In this video, we're going to create a button to check or uncheck a bunch of checkboxes you have in a column. So basically, the whole idea is going to be instead of going to this column and checking each one of these boxes one by one or unchecking them for that matter, we're just going to create a button that we can click on and make that happen. And to be able to do this, you need to first understand the idea of the checkbox. A checkbox will be a value stored in a cell, which will be basically true if it's checked and false if it's unchecked. And with that in mind, we're going to go to Tools and Script Editor. I'm going to start by naming the script. Let's zoom in a little bit here. So what I'm going to do first, I'm going to just create this piece of code here. We're going to take the spreadsheet app. And in that, we're going to get our active spreadsheet. That should refer to this entire spreadsheet with all its worksheets. In this, I want to refer to this worksheet that's called my work. So I'm going to copy that name, go back to my script and do, well, let's actually save this in a variable. And then on the next line, we'll create a variable for our worksheet. And to get to our worksheet, we'll take our spreadsheet and get sheet by name. And basically just put the name of the spreadsheet in quotes like this. Now, if you just wanted to work with the current worksheet, instead of doing this, you could do get active sheet like that, and that should be just the current worksheet that you're on. I'm just going to go with the name of the worksheet, my work. So that's what I'm going to do. So now in this worksheet, if I wanted just to basically check, let's say this box in, see, row 10 and this column G. So column G would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So column number 7, row 10. What I would do, I would go to this worksheet and do get range. And I would do row 10, comma, column number 7. That would be the cell I'm targeting. And then I will do set value of that cell to be, I'm trying to check the box, so I'm going to set it to true. If I was trying to uncheck it, I would set it to false. So right now, let's just test this script to make sure it works. So I'm going to save this. So let's just go ahead and check. See, this is not checked right now. I'm going to go back and run the script. Do all permissions. And that should run that script. Let's go take a look. See, this box is checked. If I go back and change this to false, save this and run this, that should uncheck that same box. So now we have a script that can check or uncheck a single box. So let's change this to true to check the boxes instead of unchecking them. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to go back to this get range, and instead of targeting a single cell, I'm going to convert it to a range. So I can do that by doing a comma after this, and then I can do how many rows do I want to select. So for example, if I do 10, that would be 10 rows, and that would be 10 rows starting from this 10th row in the 7th column. So that would basically go row 10, like here, column number 7, this cell, and then 10 down. Now what I'm going to do instead, I'm going to start with this first cell and then say, let's go like 12 down. So to do that, I'm just going to change this to 2 instead of 10 to start from the second row. And then I'm going to do 12. And that's actually not 12, I think that's 11. Because that's 12 rows, we have the header. So let's just change it to 11 for now. Now let's try to just run this just like this to see what happens. So as you can see, that went through. Let's go back and check. And you can see the whole thing is now checked. Now I want to add another piece to this. If we go ahead and add more rows to this, and then we have a situation like this now, if I go back and rerun this function, because now we have more rows, these two are no longer checked. So instead of hard coding the number of rows here to 11, let's just say go to the end of the data. And we'll do that by taking this worksheet instead of this 11. And in this, we'll have this get last row method, which should basically get us the row number for the last row in this worksheet. So that is going to give us 14. Now, one thing you're going to notice here, if I count how many I have here, starting from the top, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, it's not 14, it's 13 because we have this header on top. So I need to compensate for that. So if it says 14, the actual number should be 13. So I'm going to do this, then minus 1 to get to that 13. So this way, now if I run this function, see that we'll just get the whole thing. And if we do add or delete more lines, like this, if I run the function, you'll see it will automatically figure out the height of this data and basically just check all the boxes. So far, this function should check all boxes, and that's what I'm going to rename this to. I also want to have another one that is going to be unchecking all the boxes. So I guess I'm going to rename this function to check boxes. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to pass an argument to this function. I'm going to call this check. So that argument that I'm going to pass, I'm just going to replace this true with that argument check. And the reason for that is that now I could reuse that same function to check or uncheck those boxes by using that function within other functions. So I'm going to create two more functions here. One is going to be to check all the boxes. And for that, we're going to take this check boxes function. And because I want to check those boxes, this should be true. So I'm going to pass true to this. And then I'm going to just copy this, paste it below. And this will be uncheck all boxes. And we'll do false. So now if I run this uncheck all boxes function by basically selecting it here on top, if I run that, see that should uncheck all the boxes. And if I run this check all boxes function, that should check all those boxes. So now the only thing left to do is to just assign these two functions to a button so it's easier to use. So I'm going to copy this function name, check all boxes, go back to this, and I'm going to add some sort of drawing. And we'll just do some formatting here. I'm going to save and close this. I can zoom out at this point. And then I'm going to make another one for unchecking. And just put it in here, doesn't matter. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to click on check all, click on this little icon on the right corner and assign script and paste the script for, well, apparently it's not saved anymore. Let's go copy it again. paste it here, check all boxes, press OK. And I'm going to do the same for the second one. So this one is on check all boxes. So I'll copy that, go to assign script, paste it here, and press OK. And we can close this one at that point. So now we have two buttons. If I click uncheck, that should uncheck all of them. If I click check, that should check all of them. And again, just to test this, if we check a few, then do uncheck all. See, it's gone. And if we do check all, it just works. And that should be it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.